Hello everyone, welcome back to my course on reinforcement learning. This lecture will introduce the concept of optimal policy and the Bellman optimality equation. This figure shows the structure of our course. In the previous lecture, we studied the Bellman equation. In this lecture, we will study the Bellman optimality equation, a specific case of the Bellman equation that plays a crucial role in reinforcement learning. I strongly suggest you pay special attention to two core concepts and a fundamental tool in today's lecture: the optimal state value, optimal policy, and the Bellman optimality equation. We know that the goal of reinforcement learning is to find optimal policies, so it is very important to learn the concepts in this lecture. This is the outline of this lecture. It might seem a lot, but each part is relatively short. I'll start with a brief introduction. First, I will present motivating examples, followed by definitions of optimal policy and optimal state value. Then, we will thoroughly explore the Bellman optimality equation from sections 3 to 8, including what this equation looks like, how to solve it, its solutions, properties, and more. With the Bellman optimality equation, we can derive the optimal policy and also discuss its properties towards the end of the lecture. Let's begin with an example. We've seen this example several times before, and it is quite straightforward. It involves a policy pi represented by green arrows. Our task essentially involves two steps. First, solving the Bellman equation to determine state values, and second, calculating action values. On this basis, we will introduce an interesting phenomenon. First, the Bellman equation. This is also a revisit of our last lecture. It allows us to obtain an equation for every state. For instance, V pi S1. Starting from here and moving right, I receive an immediate reward of negative 1, then gamma, because I jump to S2, so the following is V pi S2. Similar equations can be obtained for other states. This set of equations can be solved in many ways since it forms a system of linear equations. If we set gamma to 0.9, we can calculate these state values. You can do the calculations on your own. I directly present the results here. After determining the state value, we can proceed to solve for the action value. How do we do this? Let's consider S1 as an example. There are 5 actions. Each action is associated with a value. For instance, let's examine action A3. If I move down from S1 by taking action A3, what would happen? First, I would receive an immediate reward of 0, followed by gamma, and then I transition to S3, which gives V pi S3. Substituting the specific values for gamma and V pi S3, we get 9. Similarly, other actions can be calculated. Why do I highlight A3 in blue? It's because, as you can see, action A3 actually corresponds to the highest action value. Now we ask an important question. The current policy is not very good because at S1 it moves to the right, leading into the forbidden area. So, the question here is, while the policy is not good, how can we improve it to get a better one? The answer lies in action value. Let's look at the current policy, which can be expressed like this. When A equals A2, moving right, its probability is 1, and for all other actions it's 0. Under this policy, we've calculated action values and discovered that A3 corresponds to the highest action value. Could we choose A3 as a new policy? Specifically, this new policy at S1 assigns a probability of 1 to action A* and a probability of 0 to all other actions, indicating that this new policy would definitely choose A*. What is A*? It corresponds to the action with the highest action value, which in this example is A3. Therefore, while the current policy moves right, the new policy pi new would move down. As you can see, moving right is not as good as moving down, since moving down can avoid the forbidden area. Why does choosing the action with the highest action value lead to a better policy? Intuitively, this is because action values can be used to evaluate actions. If I select an action with a high action value, it means I can expect to receive a lot of rewards. And consequently, the policy will be better. This is quite easy to understand intuitively. However, mathematically, it's not so straightforward. Why? Because in this example, it's quite simple. For states like S2, S4, and S3, the optimal actions are already chosen, so in such cases, choosing the action with the highest action value at S1 can lead us downward. But what if it's not the case? For example, if at S2 the action is to move up, at S4 to move down, and at S3 to move left, meaning the policy isn't optimal in other states, can we still obtain the optimal action at S1 by calculating the highest action value? There's some uncertainty here, but what I can tell you is that by repeatedly performing this process and iterating, we will eventually reach an optimal policy. That is, for every state, we choose the action with the highest action value, iterate to get a new policy, and continue iterating to refine the policy until it converges to the optimal one. The mathematical tool for analyzing this process is precisely the Bellman optimality equation.